Welcome to XXW Stabfest. This is Jack Hoffman. I'm back for another round of commentating. So, this is our EWA tribute show, like I was talking about last week. And here comes Dratzad. And, tonight, Stabfest is brought to you by Alien vs. Predator, Optimus Edition. Whoever loses, we win. Also brought to you by Snickers Vaseline. It's only satisfying if you beat it. You know, they were thinking about calling that Snickers Vaseline. You know, it would be a double whammy, but... you know, that might be racist or something. I don't know. Anyway, it'll be Backstabbing. And, Backstabbing. Versus Dr. Waffles and a mystery opponent. I guess of his choosing. I'm not really sure if it was chosen for him or how the hell he got it. But it'll be a mystery opponent. That's all I know. So here comes Bobby down to the ring. The career killer, of course. You know, he's got that Bobby trap. He can hit it out of anywhere. He's got different variations of it. He's a crazy guy. You don't want to fuck with that guy. He'll end your career, man. Don't fuck with that guy. All right, but also in this match, we've got the ultimate champion of XXW. Also, Royal Champion, EW. Here he is. The one and only Dr. Waffles. You know, leader of the Ministry of Waffles and all that good stuff. He's coming out here. For a match against Backstabber with a mystery opponent. For our first match of XSW Sunday Staff Fest EWA Tribute Show. So nobody knows who this mystery guy is going to be, I guess. See who it is. And it is... I think that's Jason Font from EWA. Yeah, Jason Font, EWA. Also known here is Neo Jason. Yeah, but I guess when you take off his mask, yes, with Jason Font, you know, has that mohawk. So we'll see how well he does here in EWA. Or my XXW. Alright, so anyway, let's get this match underway. Here we go. I guess Greg starting off with, also, when I say Greg, I mean Greg Dratzad Huffman, if you don't know, that's his real name. He doesn't use that, that's his real name, fuck it, you know, that's his real name. Alright, fuck it. Now, Dr. Wolf has got him in the chin lock. Working that chin. Alright, I guess this is the first time I think we've had a normal tag match on televised XXW. I mean, we had a last time we had a tag match, you know, we don't really have a solid tag division. Well, fuck, I'm getting mixed up. Alright, Greg tagged in Bobby. Anyway, first time we've ever had a tag match, the only time we've ever had a tag match was at XXW Genesis when Baby Bruiser Rodman took on Fuzzy and City Rebel. Of course, Fuzzy and City Rebel split up at XXW Guiding, but I don't want to get into all that since it had nothing to do with part of the match. Looks like Bobby was just laughing at Neo Jason there. I guess he doesn't really think he's a serious competitor. I mean, Bobby is like this, he's kind of like a main eventer almost, like upper mid-card, I'd say. He really strong. He's never been champion, but I think he could become one. But Neo Jason probably the least successful of these four people, but he was also the first Royal Champion in EWA, so I guess EWA, he does have some credibility. I mean, that's a title even Bobby couldn't win when he was faced. Dr. Waffles, of course, Dr. Waffles and Bobby never faced off in XXW. They did in EWA, though. So I guess this is going to be their first match together in XXW against each other. Of course, also, Dressap and Waffles, they have some past history at Ultimate Conquest when Waffles was actually able to put Dratsep away, but Dratsep, if you visit the EWA website, he said the only reason Waffles was able to beat him was because he wasn't at 100%. If he was at 100%, he would have beat him. If you watch, EWA Tuesday Tournament, Dratsep actually beat Waffles, so it's 1-1. So maybe they can break the score here tonight. Of course, it wouldn't be a 1-on-1, so I don't know if it counts. Looks like Dratsep went for clothesline, but he didn't time it right, so Neo goes for something, but they break that, and Dratsep kicks him in the face. Alright, so now they both get in. Neo's in, and here comes Bobby. Swings whips him into the south east corner, and now the north west. It attacks in Dratsep. Neo gets out of the ring. Looks like he's coming back in, though. Dratsep with some punches. But Neo throws him off. Baseball slide by Dratsa. They're out on the floor. Neo Jason. I don't think Neo Jason and Dratsa have ever been in the ring before, so it should be interesting. See how well they do against each other. Dratsa. I don't think it's a good idea. He probably wants to keep him out of the opponent's corner. But I guess no big deal. He's got him dazed and confused. Not enough to. All right. It looks like. Looks like they're going for some sort of double team. Oh, like an assisted backbreaker. Of course, backstab we know can work as a team. Because they are, I mean, they've been a team in EWA. And XXW, I mean, they're not. Of course, we don't have a tag division. So if we did have a tag division, I guess those two could team up. But Waffles and Neo, they've actually faced each other, but I don't think there's any bad blood in that feud they had. It wasn't really feud, because like I said, there was no bad blood between them. It was just business. They actually debuted together. Waffles won that match. They had a match at Ultimate Conquest, Dr. Waffles did cheat in that match, but I guess no hard feelings, right? That was a few months. That was like that was back in November, so whenever. Of course, also today is WrestleMania, but we're not going to get into that since, I mean, we're cool with WWE and all that, but we're bigger friends with EWA here, so this is their tribute show. We're not going to talk about that, despite the fact I hope Rey Mysterio wins that the main event. Alright, so anyway, back to XXW, fuck WWE, no offense there. Alright, well anyway, back to this match. We have Dratsap, and he's got a, it looks like they were going, head collision, what they call that move, smash, fucking meeting of the minds, or some shit like that, it doesn't matter, it's a double headbutt. Bobby must be pissed or something, he's got a weapon, man. He just fucking hit Waffles, man. I'm surprised the ref hasn't DQ'd. I think he just called for the DQ, man, and that was kind of stupid. I don't know why he did that. He could have kept his match going. He could have had a good match, but I guess he got pissed after that double head collision move, dilly, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, it looks like Dratsap's kind of mad about that. Hopefully there's no animosity between Bobby and Dratsap. Alright, well, I know our second match. This is contender versus contender match. This match could be really good. Bad Bonero versus Great D. They've never been in the ring together because, you know, a lot of EWA, XSW superstars are kind of mingled together. Because we're all like a big family, XSW and EWA, you know. Not Bad Bonero. He's XSW exclusive. Great D, also EWA exclusive. So these exclusive superstars are going to battle it out, kind of be the first ever XSW versus EWA match. This would be really good. Of course, Bad Bonero, he wanted that. He got his number one contendership at Genesis, so that was like over half a year ago. Anyway, here comes the Great D. He's a really good wrestler. I've seen some of his work in EW. He actually won a 25-man Royal Rumble at one of the Tuesday tournaments. Can't remember the exact date of that. I believe it was sometime last month. That's right, because April, but it was in March when he won that Rumble. Anyway, he's posing to the crowd, or maybe taunting the crowd, I'm not really sure. He's kind of, I don't know really what to make of him. He likes to dress up nice for his matches. He doesn't wear like, looks like Bad Bonero's like playing something. I bet he learned that from Mars. It looks like something Mars would do. Mars and Bad Bonero, of course, pretty good friends, so they might teach each other moves. Anyway, Great D hit him with some punches. It looks like boxer punches or something, man. I bet that guy can punch pretty fucking hard too. He just Oh shit. But Bad Bonero swings him back with a tilt roll. He's done that a few times. I guess one of his kind of signature moves, I guess you'd call it. Lifts him into the ropes, but he comes back with a leg lariat. I forgot the exact name for that move. I'll just call it a leg lariat. Back leg. Yeah, it's like a neck breaker. Oh, but reverse into a clothesline. Now Great D just stomping. That was pretty cool reverse for him. I'll give him that. And comes back with a chop. And Great D, another chop. He's just kind of chopping away on him, I guess. I don't really know. Face buster. Well, not really face buster. It was like a knee to the face kind of a deal. It looked like he was going for another one. Bad Bonero reversed it, turned into a jawbreaker there. And a super kick. Now he's just posing for the fans, I guess. Oh, Great D coming back with those punches. He's got him tangled up in the ropes now. He's just hitting him in the face. Using those ropes, I might give him some velocity. Whiplash. But Bad Bonero comes back with a jawbreaker. It's like Bad Bonero with a hip toss. It's like, yeah, hip toss. Don't really know what to talk about during this match. I don't really know too much. I mean, I've watched EWA from... It looks like he's going from... he tricked him again, man. He pointed up. Like I said, it looks like something Mars would do, so... I'm not going to get that. We already talked about that. It looks like he's trying to do it again, but... Great D is like, fuck that. I'm not going to fall for that three times. Third time's a charm, I guess. He comes back with a flying clothesline. And, looks like an elbow to the forearm or something like that. And drops an elbow. Now just kicking him. He's picking him back up for something. It looks like he's going to whip him around. Throw him out of the ring, maybe. I really don't know. Why don't we throw him out of the ring? This is like baseball slide. Let's see. I'm trying to think of from accomplishments Great D has done, but other than 25 men, he's never been pinned, that's true. He did actually lose a match because of Austin, I believe it was in a ladder match, but he wasn't pinned or anything. It was a third man, so, you know, I guess you could technically blame it on the third guy and say it's his fault that I lost the fucking match. But, you know, it's the way some matches go. He's never been pinned, like I said, or made submit for that matter, so. Only lost that triple threat. Bad Bonero only lost one match to a hothead. He blamed that on ring rust, so I guess both of them have something to blame for their only losses. These two look pretty even. Oh, it looks like Bad Bonero is going for. Oh, that's the slice. That's kind of like. That's that move that Loaf does. It's his finishing move. Like to end his matches with. But he only ended one, but he said he wanted to start ending it, so maybe if he gets some more matches. first, well, fuck, I was going to talk about Wolf. We're not going to talk about Wolf because he's not in this match. I want to go off on a tangent and whatnot. Anyway, Batman was going for a headlock. Great to escape that. I guess these two are, well, they're not rehearsing all that much because they really don't know each other that well, I guess. Because Bad Monero's from XXW, and, well, they never met in the ring. It's their first time meeting in the ring. Of course, exclusive to each other's brands. Hothead looks like, or not Hothead. Fucking Bad Monero is going for a crossface. I don't know. Maybe he wants to work the head or just kind of just. I don't really know what the game plan is for this match. Looks like he was trying to trick him early. Another spin out that. All right, folks. Anyway, he might be want to set up for the co-driver though. Oh, is he going for it? It looks like he was going for that modified sharpshooter that he does. But Grady comes back with uppercut. Of course, I really don't know the game plan for either of these guys. Bebonero, I haven't seen too. I mean, I've seen some of his matches, but he never really wanted to show a game plan. He's kind of just a catch as you can type of guy. He just goes out there and throws it all out. And I'm like, I don't really know Great D's plan either. no idea, honestly. So we'll just see what these guys can come up with here. But looks like Babanero's going for some underhook, kind of a hold. I think that's the second time he's done it here. Yeah. Oh, but they're Great D escape. Looks like Babanero kind of had that momentum there, but Great D was able to push him off and come back. So now Great D's getting out of the ring, and I guess we're going for a brawl outside. Looks like they're going up the ramp. I don't know what Great D. I don't think he's trying to leave. I think he might have some plans up there or something. Like I said, I don't really know the guy, but he's supposed to be pretty strong, so I don't think he's gonna run away from the fight. You know, he's got a reputation out there. You know, he's like a big business type guy, movie star. I don't really know, but he wants people to take him seriously. I know that, and he wants to make EWA look good here. He wants to make, yeah. So anyway, that's what the Great D's all about, I guess. They're going to get fucking counted out, though, if they keep this up. Fucking shit. I think that... well, that sucked. I think that's first count out naked 650, I don't know. Anyway. Oh, yeah, and Miffin vs. Scumbag. EWA chairman will be representing EWA and the Black Hole and Inferno at our anniversary show. All right, so anyway... I mean, that should be a good pay-per-view match, I guess. But anyway, right, we gotta talk about this man right here, Sonny Stafford. Miffin will be, of course, chairman of EWA. He'll be taking on his top champ of EWA, but it will be for the Chaotic title here tonight in a steel cage. A lot of people get this messed up. They think, I mean, the Royal title in EWA is a mid-card title. That's what I'm seeing. But in XSW, the Chaotic title, they think it's a mid-card title. It's not the mid-card title. It's a hardcore title. And it's not like a hardcore title as in, like, I mean, there's a lot of chaos, but it's not like for just your average guy can come in there and, like, WWE or you know, they got rid of the hardcore title, but they had that 24/7 role where anybody win it. But this isn't about, I mean, these are big guys that win this. Mark Red, Nibber, there's the only two that hold it, and you know how strong they are, man. I mean, Mocker, he put up a hell of a fight against Drasev, who was first ever Ultimate champion. And so these guys can match strength with the main eventers. Well, actually, they are a main event, really. It depends. I mean, enough for that. We're going to get on this match. There's Miffin here. Looks like, Miffin started off the attack. Nibber looks like he came back with a few jabs. Miffin looks like he regains control with a reverse DDT. Now, game plan here, like I've talked about before. Nibber, he's not too interested in like, finishing off his opponents. He likes to have fun. He likes to do a wrestling match. He's not, like, he doesn't think his record is in jeopardy. I don't even know if he really cares. He just kind of wins matches because he's really hard to beat, you know? I think he just wants a good fight, whether he wins or loses. Miffin, don't really know. He has that slam dunk. I'd say he's a rising star, but he hit him with super kick. Anyway, I'd say Miffin is kind of a rising guy. He's not. Oh, that was a nice close on. Like off the ropes, just I like that. All right, but anyway, I'm You know, there's too much to talk about like that. Another one of those nice flying clotheslines. Anyway, like I said, I think Miffin's like a rising star. You know, he's done pretty well. He put up a hell of a fight up against Dratsab at Ultimate Punch Plus. Another super kick. But I don't really know. I mean, he's a good wrestler and all. Don't know his game plan. Game plan. Miffin doesn't really seem to have a game plan. A lot of these EWA guys don't really have too much strategy. I mean, I better not go there because we'll get trampled. But anyway, never with a choke slam. But these EWA guys, I don't know. They're kind of weird, man. I'm gonna be honest with you. anyway, Miffin. It looks like he's working the legs, but I don't. A lot of these EWA guys are very inconsistent with their attack strategies. One minute they'll be working legs, they'll do the arms, and they won't. They don't go anywhere with it. That's one thing I think XXW has. Everybody, well, not everybody. Some of the people in XXW are fucking crazy too. Like, I'm not even gonna mention names, but I don't know. We'll see where this goes. It's a cage match, so of course, game plan. I guess. Well, it looks like he's going back to those legs. Maybe he does have a game plan. Maybe he wants to take out those legs so Nimber can't get over the cage. Or maybe hit those big boots. You know, he has ended a match with a big boot before. He actually beat M-Man with a big boot. But not like it's hard to beat M-Man. I mean, he's got fucking 4 losses, no wins, right? Or, I don't even remember. One day I'm going to fuck it. M-Man's a good guy, but he's not in this match. I mean, he's cool. I'm cool with him. I just like to make fun of people every once in a while, you know what I mean? So anyway, Nimber's coming back with his forearm. Speaking of commentary, we were trying to get some other EWA guys to do commentary, but I guess none of them were available or something. I don't know. We had management problems, so they got me back on doing commentary, which is pretty good too, I guess, since I do have I do know a little bit about EWA. I've watched their shows. It's pretty good. And we're good friends with EWA. A lot of our stars are crossover stars, of course. We're the original, you know. But EWA, they're good, too. Not as good, but they're still good. It looks like Miffin is going for another one of those super kicks. He's done that a few times this match. Sammy might be a little pissed that he's still in his move, honestly. Well, it looks like Nimber came back with a reverse atomic drop. That's a good move, I guess. Now, Nimber climbing top turnbuckle. Overshot the move again. Remember we saw that last week. And it was last week. Yeah. Alright. Anyway. Oh, looks like he's going for a choke slam. There he goes. You know, I want to end the match right now. Might not. I don't really know. Maybe he's not too worried about any matches. I think he's thinking. Yeah, he wants to go for another choke. I think he was thinking about leaving on. He's like, nah, I got some more. I'm gonna make this match good. I don't know if he's really cared. Oh, looks like he's gonna slam his face into the cage. He goes for another choke slam. Nimber, you know, some people want to make the match look good for the fans, so the fans will care about him and stuff. I don't even know if Nimber thinks that. I think he just wants a good fight. He can give a fuck what the fans think. I mean, not that he doesn't like the fans, but he's kind of a guy that's for himself, you know. He just wants to go out there and have some fun, kick some ass, win some titles, I guess. He is the chaotic champion, hardcore champion. It looks like Miffin's leaving after that nice backbreaker type thing on the neck. Does some damage to the neck, some back. I don't know. It looks like he's trying to get the fuck out of there. Nibber has got to do something. There he shakes him off the cage. I think Miffin needs to learn his fucking balance, though. I mean, it's just shaking the fucking cage. Hell, I could hold on to that cage. So what if somebody shakes it? He can still get off. But Nibber with the body slam. I think he's climbing the cage too early, though. I don't think he's going to win with a body slam. I mean, that would be kind of silly, ridiculous if he won with a body slam. I mean, could you imagine someone winning a cage match with a move that simple? I mean, that just seems kind of silly to me. I don't see... Well, hell, he won with the body slam. What do you know? I wasn't expecting that to happen. Well, there you go. Nibber, your winner. I gotta admit, I knew Nibber was gonna win. I mean, you actually think Niffin? All right, I'm not gonna make fun. Well, hell, Nimber, he's hard. He's a hard guy to be. I think. Oh yeah. We gotta go now. Our time is up. But there you have it. End of the show. Hope you enjoyed the EWA tribute show. Peace out, guys. Jack Hoffman.